Let's make this cute-ass bento box. Not for your kids, not for your significant other, but for yourself, cause you deserve nice things too. Push, push. Oops. Push that shit aside. Add lots of veggies for nutrients, so you can live longer. Add sesame seeds and furikake, because it looks not good. How you pronounce it. Wowzers. It's so beautiful.
Making the bento from Your Name. Your Name is one of my favorite anime movies. Start with some rice. I cut the face out of some seaweed with the seaweed cutter. I use the same pan to make tamagoyaki, fry my sausages and potatoes with some salt and pepper. I assemble everything in the bento with some cherry tomatoes and broccoli. This was so much fun to make. Let me know what you want me to recreate next.
I have been waiting to put together this mushroom-themed bento for months now, so here it is, finally. Started with some cucumber and orange pepper, I cut out the center of the cucumber and added a little piece of orange pepper in the shape of a mushroom. And no, the extras don't go to waste. I also added some of these white truffle potato chips and some of these choco rooms, which were really hard for me to get a hold of, but I finally got them. I also added some strawberries and blackberries. And then for the main course, we're going with some breaded mushrooms. In these two mushroom side containers, I added some ketchup and some ranch. And I also got out two food picks that I put into the breaded mushrooms when they were done. Like I said, I've been waiting to put this lunch together for so long now, and I'm so happy with how it turned out. I hope you guys enjoy.
For my husband's lunch today, I'm going to pack in this little salad that I whipped up. It's just cucumber, tomatoes, red onion with a little bit of balsamic vinegar and olive oil. For the fruit, I have this plum, I think. Maybe it's a nectarine, but mainly I got these because the outsides look really funny. Reminds me of like reptile skin or something, but either way, they taste really good and they're sweet. Lastly, I packed in some walnuts and a couple Oreos. And for the main portion, I'm doing some spaghetti. For the pasta sauce, it's pretty much shashuka, which I think I pronounced that right. I take those veggies minus the egg and place it into a blender, which then becomes your sauce. For the protein, I did some spicy garlic shrimp. And I get this question a lot, but I always make sure the bottom portion is nice and cool before I stack the top layer. Since most days I pack the lunch the day before and it's kept in the fridge until my husband takes it away in the morning. Now that the lunch is ready to go, I of course include a note for my husband.
Let's make a super duper cute bento box for yourself again. I made chicken teriyaki. Mix. Fix. Fix. Add veggies so you can pretend you're healthy. Sauce it up. One more chicken for extra protein. Sprinkle sesame seeds.
Fuck my life.
Oh my god.
I opened the wrong hole. That's what he said. Let's pretend everything is okay. Pack some apples for help. Push, push. JK, nothing is going right today. WTF. This apple did not make it in the cut. Dip apples in yogurt, it's yummy, trust me. Mix, mix. I'm still crying. This was the ugliest bento box. I'm sorry, I have failed you all. Better luck next time.
Here's how I put together today's dinosaur-themed bento. I picked dinosaur out of my little mystery bag. Here's all the accessories that I'm using. I have some picks, some silicone liners, and some little cutters. I started by mixing up this kale and edamame salad. I put it into the box and topped it with some tiny pieces of cucumber that I cut into little dinosaur shapes. For the fruit, I went with a mango and some blackberries and added two dinosaur picks on top. I also put in some of these all-dressed potato chips, and I decided to add two more picks to the salad. For the main course, I put some of these dino nuggets into the air fryer, and instead of using barbecue sauce this time, I used some Chick-fil-A sauce. I put the nuggets in the box when they were done, and that was it. Because we have a holiday on Monday, I'm going to be able to make extra bentos this week, so I'm super excited. Another popular bento theme that people are requesting is colors of the rainbow. So I'm going to start with red and work my way through all of the colors. I started by adding one of these cherry cheesecake packs into the box and topped it with some red sprinkles. I also added a Babybel cheese, which I cut a little heart into, and some cherry tomatoes with a side of ranch dressing. And I know the leaf picks are green, but I still think they look cute. For the fruit, I added some strawberries and raspberries with two red heart picks. The main course is a little bit complicated to explain, but it's basically just spaghetti with homemade marinara sauce and a hot dog, which I cut so that it kind of looks like an octopus, except with four legs. There was probably a better way to explain that, but I think you get the idea. So yeah, here's the red lunch. Can't wait for the rest of the rainbow.
Pack lunch with me. I made Thai basil chicken. It smells amazing, but people might complain at work, so I have to eat my lunch outside.
Damn, look at that egg.
Me subtly trying to show off my cute pink spoon rest. These kiwis better be good because I hate cutting them. My cute lunch bag. Apple Watch Flex. Wowzers.
Break up, Bento. I know you probably don't really feel like eating right now, but I wanted to make you something special. I wrote this little message on the seasoned rice. It says fight, which means to keep on going because you're doing great. I read online that unagi is supposed to help improve your stamina, so I put that in as well. Broccoli is super nutrient dense, and I also included a heart-shaped egg and some marinated bamboo shoots. Finally, I wanted to write a little encouraging message for you. I know that this is a tough time right now, but you are loved. And of course, pack it with something sweet. And that's how I make a...
She ain't trying it. He keep calling me crime. Dance, how you kill this? I understood the assignment. I understood the assignment. I understood the assignment. I understood the assignment.
How to make Sailor Moon bentos. Luna rice is made with taro powder and Artemis is jasmine rice. At Tonkatsu. Add vegetables and seaweed salad. Add pickled veggies and tonkatsu sauce. Enjoy!
Just look at this thing. Absolutely gorgeous.
So fucking good.
Shout out to Rengoku.
This might look like an ordinary bento box, but it's actually self-heating. It's called an ekiben, which also means train station bento because you buy them at the train station. There are various different types, like this bullet train themed bento. Got the self-heating one, chose the large size, of course. There are ekiben stands on the train platform just in case you forget before your train comes. And there it is, it's the self-heating beef tongue bento. All you have to do is pull this string and you can start to see the steam coming out. After a little bit, it started getting pretty toasty, and this is what the inside of the heating mechanism looks like. The food was pretty warm, and the beef was really tender. definitely recommend getting it when you're on a bullet train. Doing it's not style. I'ma pick you up in a Cadillac like a gentleman. Bring it glamour black. Keep it real to real in the way I feel. I could walk you down the aisle. I wanna do you like Michael. I wanna kiss you like Prince.
Let's make lunch for me and my friends. Actually, growing up, I would have loved to share my food with my friends at school, but the truth is, they weren't really interested in what I was bringing with me for lunch. I think it's normal as a kid to want to dress the way everyone dresses, talk the way everyone talks, and even eat what everyone else eats. And for me, the scariest place at Highland Elementary was the cafeteria. My grandmother insisted on not just packing me a strange pseudo-Korean-American fusion lunch, but she did so in this hideous yellow Cabbage Patch Kids lunchbox that looked incredibly out of place next to all the cool brown bag lunches around me. I would soon retire that lunchbox, as well as my grandmother's lunches, in favor of pizza and french fries. It wasn't until my senior year in high school that I started bringing Korean food with me for lunch again. One day, Dan, a kid in theater with me, sat down next to me as I ate and asked, "What's that?" at my kimbap. "Oh, it's kimbap, rice with seaweed and a bunch of good stuff in the middle." He licked his lips as if transfixed. "You want some?" "Do I ever?" And I split my lunch in half with him, and to this day, I have Dan to thank for making the cafeteria a little less scary for me.
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Yo, bro, who got you smiling like that? Like,
yellow lights, so baby, close your eyes.